You are about to start the audiobook of the book review of Room, a famous work by Emma Donoghue. During this reading, you will first discover a brief context of the work and its author. Then, a summary of the work will be presented, followed by an analysis of the characters and the key points of the novel. Once these different points have been addressed, all that remains is to conclude this listening session with a few questions that may further fuel your reflection. The author. Emma Donoghue grew up in Dublin before relocating to Ontario, Canada in 1998. She studied English and French at University College Dublin before gaining a PhD from the University of Cambridge. She has worked full-time as a writer since she was 23 and lives with her partner and their two children. Donoghue has written 9 novels, along with short stories, several plays, and 2 screenplays. She has recently branched out into children's fiction with her The Lotteries series. Although she has worked with many genres, she is best known for her works of historical fiction, focusing, amongst other things, on the unsolved murder of the cross-dressing Jenny Bonnet in 1876 and the Codrington Affair, a divorce that gripped 19th-century Britain. Donoghue's works have been translated into over 40 languages and she has won multiple awards, including the Golden Crown Literary Award and the American Library Association's Gay and Lesbian Book Award. The work. Inspired in part by the real-life story of Elizabeth Fritzl, held captive by her father for 24 years, Room is told from the unique perspective of Jack, a 5-year-old boy who has spent his entire life locked in a single room with his ma. Ma was abducted as a teenager, giving birth to the precocious yet naive Jack in captivity. She shields him from the true horror of his situation, hiding the existence of the world from him in this tale of hope, innocence, and the bond between a mother and child. An international bestseller, Room was shortlisted for the Man Booker Prize and was named one of the New York Times 6 best fiction titles of 2010. Donoghue adapted Room for the screen herself in 2015. The film, starring Brie Larson and Jacob Tremblay, was nominated for 4 Academy Awards, including Best Picture. Summary. A birthday celebration. We meet Jack, the narrator of the book, on his 5th birthday and are quickly introduced to the world in which he lives. Very quickly, in fact, because Jack has never left a room, the space of 11 square feet in which he lives with Ma. Ma gives Jack a drawing of himself for a present and the two get on with their day, eating a carefully measured out breakfast, watching Dora the Explorer and playing sports games to keep fit. After dinner, they make a birthday cake, though Jack becomes upset when he learns that there are no candles. Ma calms him down and they read a story before Jack goes to bed inside the wardrobe to hide from a man he knows only as Old Nick. He explains that Old Nick often comes at night to visit Ma, bringing supplies and making the bed creak, although he does not visit on Jack's birthday. The next day they carry out the same routine of bathing, eating, playing, learning, screaming at skylight, napping and watching TV. Jack delights in finding a live mouse in Room. That night, Old Nick does visit, and Ma rejects his offer of a present for Jack. Jack cannot understand why she would do this and becomes angry with Ma. When he wakes up the next day, there is a new remote control Jeep for him. The following night, Jack accidentally knocks the remote and the Jeep falls on Old Nick, who attacks Ma in response. The unbelievable truth. The next day, Ma is snappy but continues with the normal routine. Jack's curiosity is growing, and when he asks how the TV contains the same painkillers that Ma takes, Ma tells him that everything you see on the TV is real. She then spends the day gone, Jack's way of describing her depressed, unresponsive state. When she returns to herself, Jack continues to ask which things on TV are real, unable to fully believe it. Ma learns that Old Nick has lost his job so is short on money. When he offers Jack a lollipop, Jack ventures out of the wardrobe, which causes Ma to scream and Old Nick to become angry. In response, Old Nick cuts off Room's electricity for 3 days, leaving Jack and Ma cold and hungry. Ma reveals to Jack that she used to live in the world outside of Room with her own parents. Old Nick kidnapped her as a teenager and has kept her locked up for 7 years. Escape at last. Jack struggles to comprehend all that he has learned about the world outside of Room. Ma meanwhile fears what Old Nick might do if he cannot afford to stay in his house and plots to escape. She decides that if Jack pretends to be ill, Old Nick will take him to the hospital and he can pass a note to a doctor. However, Old Nick refuses to take Jack, so Ma moves on to plan B.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.